Is gun control in America possible? Every day, 318 people are shot. 46 of them are children. 96 of them will die. This leads to 116,225 people being shot per year, and over 30,000 of them will die. This is the highest gun murder rate in any developed country. When looking at our rate per 100,000 people, America is more than all of the other countries combined. Now, to know why our gun violence rates are so high, you have to look at the American mindset. America is known as the land of the free. It's in our national anthem. Every American has probably used "it's a free country" as a comeback. And the principle is our country, and freedom was the principle our country was built on. So why is freedom so closely tied to firearms? The notion that since we're a free nation makes many Americans feel as if they are entitled to own a gun or a firearm, and as that's like what our founding fathers used to gain our freedom. Many will also cite their Second Amendment. However, guns have changed dramatically from when the Second Amendment in the Constitution was written. For example, a modern AR-15 can shoot 15 times the amount of ammo in 1 minute than the typical revolutionary musket, plus it has way more precision and accuracy. So why are we still clinging to our guns even after the mass violence that follows? Any other product with a mortality rate this high would have been banned a long time ago. For example, when Pinto car gas tanks were exploding, they were recalled almost immediately after 27 deaths. When Tylenol tablets were accidentally poisonized with cyanide in the 80s, protectionary medicine caps were put on them and seals, and were recalled after 7 deaths. But guns are still allowed to be purchased after there's 32,000 deaths only per year for decades or centuries of not this exact murder rate, but they've been killing and hurting Americans for centuries. But since we're conditioned to learn guns equal protection and freedom and being American, many refuse to let this go. Being American means being free, not only owning a gun. Being free to feel safe in our schools, being free not to hear gunshots outside our houses, and being free to know that you won't die in a preventable tragedy. So I propose some solutions to reduce our gun violence rates without banning all guns outright, because I don't think that's the solution. So one thing that we need is stricter background checks to ensure that only law-abiding, gun-owning citizens should be able to like purchase and own these. So for example, like a stricter background check, making sure that they have no domestic violence or like violent offenses in general, and creating a database to put all these offenders in, because many shooting perpetrators have gone through loopholes in the system. Like the Virginia Tech shooter was like registered as not supposed to be able to buy a gun, but the gun store didn't have those records, so he was still able to buy the gun. Raising the purchasing age, as many studies show that our brains don't develop until we're at least 25, so why are we still able to buy guns at 18? So I think we should at least raise it to 21, because you can't even buy a drink in America at 18, so why can you own a literal death weapon? Next, I think we should ban automatic and semi-automatic weapons, even though most automatic weapons are illegal, but semi-automatics, like AR-15s, are still able to be purchased. And Nicholas Cruz, the shooter of the Parkland shooting, was only 18 and was able to buy an AR-15 to use over a dozen of his classmates. We need to establish a culture of gun safety by promoting that guns should only be owned in a safe, like protective manner, and they're not just to just kill people. And although most people don't think that, but with this culture of like video games and violence that we often see, it can be hard to see that. And also in like inner cities and stuff, we need to promote that and start at the root of the problem to stop this gun violence, because it's not just these mass tragedies that we see in the media. It's also like built into many like cities that we see, and often we don't hear about that or individual cases there. And that leads to my next point, which is reducing violence in high-risk communities with resources and support and stopping the problem at the root. So by like creating more resources and support in these communities that are so often like affected with gun violence and the ones that we don't see every day is really important because they are like minorities and kids living in inner cities often see most of their are the ones most affected by gun violence and like make psychological tests and classes mandatory, which relates to like my stricter background checks, which is like making sure that all people that have bought a gun are like sane enough to own it, because a lot of times like the Waffle House shooter was deemed not able to have a gun, but his guns were just given to his dad, who gave them right back to him. So that obviously didn't work, and that should be put to like databases and make classes mandatory for, because like just even hunting licenses you need to get you need to take classes for. So I think classes should be mandatory for anyone who wants to buy a gun. So as you've seen recently, a lot of protests and arguments have erupted recently with Parkland students like recently bringing up this debate. And when I first started this, when I first made this presentation, there were, I think, three less shootings that had happened this year. Already three have happened since I started, including most notably the Santa Fe shooting. So it shows that that was seriously preventable, because people have been talking about this before. The March for Our Lives was before that. And so many of these like shooters show warning signs, and I think that we just need to band together as a country to protect our kids and protect everyone who lives in America and wants to live their life here.